Hello and welcome to our first video of semester two. This is 3.1, step one. Our learning objective for this lesson as a whole is that you'll be able to read chapter one of our book for this unit, While the Locust Slept, and understand its historical context and setting. So for this first step, before you start reading, our goal is to figure out what is this book about and why are we reading it? So let's start with the basics. The name of the book is While the Locust Slept, and we'll be talking more about that name as we go on. What's a locust? What does it have to do with this story? Why is it sleeping? What's going on? So keep an eye out for that as we continue. The genre is memoir or autobiography, which means that it is a real story told by the person who lived it. So the author, Peter Raiser, is sharing his actual life, events that happened to him, in order to show us his story. The book was published by the Minnesota Historical Society in 2001, so it has local, historical, ongoing relevance. So who's Peter Raiser? His full name is James Peter Raiser, but he goes by Peter Raiser. He lived from 1928 to 2022, and this book was actually the first he wrote, and he published it when he was 72 years old. So he was not a writer for most of his life, but at 72, his family encouraged him to collect his story and his memories into this book, which is what we're going to be reading. He is a member of the Fond du Lac Band of Minnesota Chippewa, also called Anishinaabe or Ojibwe, and he was born and lived his life here in Minnesota. So there's several key places in Minnesota that will come up in the story. You can see circled there is the reservation for the Fond du Lac Band of Lake Superior, so that is where Raiser's family was originally from. He is born in St. Paul. And several other key locations in the story include Owatonna, Rushford and Houston, and Caledonia, as well as up in Superior. So Raiser was born very close by in St. Paul, Minnesota, but he was abandoned by his family at a very young age, less than 1 year old. So he spent his first 15 years as a ward of the state at the state school in Owatonna. Essentially, he was an orphan who had no family, but the state of Minnesota was responsible for looking after him. At age 15, the school sent him on a farm placement where he would live with a family on a farm and work for them, in theory, also being part of their family. He worked on several farm placements from the ages of 15 to 18. So you've heard me mention several terms, Anishinaabe, Ojibwe, or Ojibwa, and Chippewa. Overall, these terms all refer to the same indigenous group. Anishinaabe is the name that these people gave themselves. It means the original people. And when settlers from other countries came over, they were also given the names Ojibwe and Chippewa. Again, these all refer to the same groups, this particular indigenous group in the United States and in Canada. And certain members prefer one term or another, but they generally refer to the same group. So you will see them sometimes used interchangeably. Raiser was separated from his family for a long time. He was not born on the reservation. He was kept separate from his family who was alive while he was at the state school. And for most of his life, he was taught that Anishinaabe culture was dirty and uncivilized. But as an adult, once he had left the system, he started having some curiosity. And as he himself said, I studied Indian culture, my roots, and contrary to what I heard as a child, found it beautiful. One of his main sources was the book shown on screen here, Chippewa Customs, which was published in 1929, He also was able to connect with tribal elders and learn more about his personal family history, including that his great-grandmother was well known for her beadwork. So he was able to get back in touch with these elements. But why was he separated from them in the first place? In America, there was a history of Indian boarding schools from 1879 through the 1970s, not that long ago. These boarding schools were government entities that had the goal of taking Native children and essentially forcing them to assimilate. Think back to Raising the Sun. Forcing them to adopt the dominant American culture and to lose any connections to their indigenous heritage. Peter Raiser wasn't at an Indian boarding school, but he was at a state school that followed many of these same philosophies. The goal, as is shown in that quote at the top, was to kill the Indian and save the man, or save the child. So in other words, the goal was to take this person and get rid of every trace of indigenous culture, leaving only a person who could blend in with the dominant culture. This idea was put forward by Captain Richard H. Pratt in 1879. He worked at Carlisle Industry School, and he said that the U.S. government had a duty to Americanize Native children, to force them to fit in. So this is why Peter Raiser was separated from much of his culture and told that Anishinaabe culture was wrong. We'll be tracing three main themes in the book growing out of these ideas. The first one is growing up in the margins. What does it mean to be a child or young adult who doesn't quite fit in, who is pushed to the side for one reason or another? How does that affect you? Our second theme is standing up to oppression. When people or society is holding you down, what can you do to resist and to regain your rights? And finally, the subjectivity of truth. How can truth mean something different to different people? How can people have different perspectives of the same things? And how can truth be twisted by people with power to control those who don't have power? So here are a couple pictures of Peter Raiser as a child. He is on the right in that right side image, along with one of his brothers. And here is Peter Raiser as an adult. As you start reading While the Locust Slept, remember that this is Raiser's true story. He is sharing what his life was like to help us understand Minnesota not too long ago from his perspective. I hope you enjoy the start of the book, and I'm really excited to hear what you will all think about it and learn from it.